This is Jeff Perlman, founder and CEO of Xojo, and in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to manage the user interface when updating a database. Now, if you haven't watched the connecting to a database, querying a database, and updating a database videos, you'll probably want to watch those first. The issue is that when there's no row selected in the list box, these fields should be disabled. Otherwise, the user is going to think that they can enter text in here, and that's going to do something. And there's buttons that should be disabled as well, the delete button and the save button. So let's start with those. I'm going to click on the delete button and disable it. So turn off the enabled property, same with save. Okay, now we need to disable all these. And we could do this in code one field at a time, one control at a time. But there's actually an easier way to do this. I'm going to grab a canvas control of all things and I'm going to set this aside for a second, and now I'm going to grab all of these controls, and I'm going to move them off the layout. Then I'm going to put in their place this canvas control. And then drop all these controls back on top of the canvas control. And you can see that the canvas control has turned red. That's indicating that these controls are parented, that the border rather has turned red. So they're parented to this control. Okay, there we go. Now, to disable them or enable them, I can simply disable or enable the parent control, in this case, the canvas. So by default, I'm going to go ahead and disable it. Okay, next we need to enable or disable the canvas control in the list box here. So I'm going to go to the list box, the results list box, go to selection changed. And if there's a row selected, well, now I need to enable that canvas. So set that to true. And of course we disabled buttons. So let's go ahead and set those to true as well. The delete button and the save button. Okay. So now those things will be enabled if there's a row selected. And if there is not one selected, then let's disable them. So I'm going to copy this real quick, paste it down here, and then just set these to false. Great. Now, last but not least, if there's no row selected, then we want to clear out the contents of all of the fields, because there might have been a row selected before and now there isn't one. So we don't want to leave the information from the old row in there. Now, last but not least, we need to set current row equal to nil, because in this case, there's no row selected. So we want to make sure that the code knows that there's no row selected. Now, next we need to deal with the new button. So let's go over there. And if the user clicks the new button, then we're going to want to make sure that there's no row selected in the list box. So we're going to set the selected row index equal to -1. That will unselect any row. And of course, we need to know that our controls are enabled. So let's set the canvas to enabled. And we'll set the save button to enabled. And finally, let's set current row equal to nil. Once again, since there's no row selected. Great. So here's our finished product. So I'm going to type in a name, and you can see that the fields are disabled. And if I click on a row, we've of course filled them in, and now they're enabled, and the buttons are enabled. And if I select somewhere in the list box where there is no row, now there's no selection, and you can see the buttons and the fields are disabled again. That's exactly how we would want it to work. Now, in this video and the previous videos in this series, all of the database table column access has been done explicitly, as you can see in the highlighted code here. I accessed each individual control or column in the database individually. And I did that so that you could understand what's going on. But the reality is that you can write generic code that prevents you from having to do all of this. You just have to plan accordingly for it. And to see how that works, check out the next video in this series called Using the DBKit Class. To learn more about Xojo, click below to subscribe to this channel, check out the other videos, and visit Xojo.com.